Josh Spiegel's Yiddish word of the day. Now, yesterday, Scott, you had excused yourself to the powder room to do a key bump. And while you were out, I said, someone's asking to come to my show next week at Magoobie's Wednesday night. They want to come and quote unquote support. And then they immediately ask for 4 free tickets. And I go, well, that's not supporting. You're barnacling
on. Moral, not financial.
Yeah, well, I need financial because it's a door deal. And Josh, you said you said a word.
Oh, I said Chazer.
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 It's literally, never heard that word before. How do we spell
Chazer?
How do you get the hold on, don't tell us. We got to figure out. What is the Chazer? How do you write that out?
There's got to be a C-H.
There's a Z in there?
A-Z-E-R.
Oh, wait, what is it?
C-H-A-Z-E-R.
Chazer.
It's literally a pig, but normally used to describe someone who takes and takes and takes.
Messy eater. Oh. A glutton. Someone selfish. A literal pig. Chazer. Sometimes in certain dialects, Josh, I read the Ashkenazi will spell it with a G.
Oh.
A chazer. That's one of Josh's Jewish words of the day. Oh, but it didn't stop there because he had more, and I loved them all. One of my favorite things about the Yiddish language, when you speak it, you scratch your throat, which is nice. If I got a sore throat, it helps give it a little bit of an itch.
Well, this probably is, this goes along with whoever asked you for the free tickets. That would be a nudnik.
Oh, a nudnik.
A pest.
Yeah.
There we go. A nudnik.
Don't be a nudnik. Stop being a nudnik, Joe.
Don't be a nudnik. Computer.
Nudnik.
I love it. Nudnik.
Nudnik.
Meaning derogatory, pestering, nagging, irrational, irritating, or a bore.
Oh, my God. You're such a nudnik.
Now, do you know a lot of Yiddish words or no?
I know putz.
Because I'm looking at a lot of them here, and I don't know, maybe just growing up on Long Island, I was exposed to them more.
Yeah,
or,
you
like,
were.
Like, were you exposed? Yeah, I guess maybe
you
I was.
It's true.
No,
you
yeah.
were.
That's
yeah.
what I'm saying,
because
I mean, a lot of these are very familiar to me.
Okay, I know chutzpah. We're going to schlep our way over.
Bupkis?
Bupkis. You're getting nothing.
Yeah, that's on my list.
Oh, like, bupkis is classic.
I went to a bar and thought I'd score. Instead, I got bupkis.
Yeah. I got bupkis. Oh, I love it. I love it. Here's one. I'm looking at a list. I didn't know this off the top of my head. Balabusta.
Oh, okay.
Do you know what that is?
That's like a balabusta is somebody who's knowledgeable in something. Like
It seems to be knowledgeable in a very specific.
Yeah, like who runs the house.
He knows
like
his. Yes, yeah. He knows his Yiddish. A perfect, educated, fine homemaker.
Right.
Oh, what a balabusta.
You are.
Oh, I love learning new words. I've said this one quite a bit. You'll find me quietly in the hallway. Alkavetch. Okay.
That's on the list here.
Complain? Oh, that means to complain,
yeah.
Right?
Complain or whine. Hey, don't be such a kvetch. Give me another one. Give me another one.
That was all that's on my list, but hey,
I got some here. Okay. Obviously, schmooze. Everyone knows what schmooze is. Hang out, mix and mingle. Schmaltz.
Schmaltz is like seasoning. It's like fat.
Yes, rendered chicken or goose fat. Yeah. Schmaltz. Shtick. We all know what shtick is.
Hi.
You guys are shtick.
Mm-hmm. Hello.
Schlep.
Schlep is to carry something, drag something.
Here's another
nosh,
one.
Obviously.
Eat some food.
Yeah, that's right.
You ever heard of a plots?
Yeah, like
plots
sounds faint. Or to collapse.
A plots means to burst, shatter, crack, fall over, or explode.
Wow.
To give in. Give me an example that, when old man speaks.
Father Spiegel. He used to
when he comes with plots onto the couch?
Well, it's more of well, at least in his case, it was more dramatic. It would be like, you know, if I'm aggravating him, he's like, Josh, don't make me plots. You're going to make me plots. I'm going to, or if he's getting he's getting lightheaded, he's seeing blood. Oh, I'm going to plots.
I'm going to plots.
Yeah.
Oh, here's Tchotchke one. Is also Tchotchke. Yiddish. Yeah. Tchotchke. What about kaputz? Is kaputz Yiddish?
I don't know if that's Yiddish. It sounds Yiddish.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, it's called kaputz.
Kaputz, you're kaputz, as in nothing, over, done, right? Ah, you're gone kaput.
What about schmuck?
Schmuck, hi.
Oh, schmuck is a penis.
You sit across from one. Tachlis. T-A-C-H-L-I-S.
Okay, wait, give me a second. I got to think.
Okay.
Tachlis. What's the top? What's the bottom line?
Yeah. Get to the point. Don't sugarcoat it. That's it.
Get down to the brass tacks.
Get right to it. Come on. But beating around the bush.
Meat and potatoes.
Don't sugarcoat it. Tachlis me. Okay? That feels good to say. Meshugana.
Oh, that's crazy person.
That's exactly what it is. And here's one of my favorite. Oi.
Oi. Oh, I don't know that one.
Oi.
No, oi is like an exclamation.
Can oy. That be... Okay, it's an expression of dismay or woe.
Yeah.
But can that be like in like Hawaii, aloha can be both goodbye and hello?
Oh.
Oi. Can you be excited about oi? Like, oi! Look at all this!
Or... I think so.
Look
yes.
at that spread. Oh my God. Oh, I love Bubby. You're my Bubby.
Yeah. Grandmother.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How about one final one here? How about Mamouche?
Mamouche.
Mamouche.
How do you spell that?
M-A-M-O-S-H.
Oh, Mamish.
Mamish, excuse me. Mamish.
Oh, it's like, it's literally, it's literally. Spring outside. It's literally.
It's literally.
Is that what it's the definition?
It's literally exactly what it is. It's literally. It's Mamouche time to do sports. Wow. I love learning new cultures. Next week, we're going to do Joe's Spanish word of the day. Joe has 6 days to learn Spanish.